BC. That's your guy, Cotter.
There he is, Sisselberger. Mike Sisselberger was the fifth overall pick in the PLL draft. All these coaches kind of coveted one or two faceoff guys in that draft a month ago. Sisselberger was the prize pick, and it went to Coach Bates and Archer. So now they were last place last year in overall faceoff wins. So they got their guy to turn that around this year.
And it's an offense that scored more goals than any team in the PLL. And they assisted at an elite level too, number one in that category. So you give this big time offense more juice, more opportunities. I don't know.
We will see how it all translates. Bones Kelly, the veteran from North Carolina, will face off opposite of Mike Sisselberger, the rookie from Lehigh. False start. Now Matty Palin gives him the whistle and we're underway. Sisselberger won the clamp, but he wasn't able to corral the ground ball. Now Latrell Harris does, though. Archer's with the ball first.
Archer's one of the most creative teams using the substitution box. Curious to see how they play out this 32-second shot clock.
Aim it.
Come under! Hammer!
Shot clock winding down. Ryan had
17 goals last year.
Both these teams with 21 combined shots before they were able to get their first goal of the game. So now let's see if the offenses can get settled in here a little bit.
A nice loose ball pickup there by Reese. Another free agent addition by these Cannons. He's a legit two-point threat. Watch for him. He's got a cannon.
Saw Gittleman back out on the field. Kavanaugh takes the shot. It's deflected by Harris.
For Marcus's journey through youth lacrosse to Gilman High School, Ryan Boyles High School.
Yeah, I was going to say, boy, you ever watch Holman play in high school? The one thing that jumped out at me was uncommon passion, uncommon energy and exuberance and a love of the game. Like, he didn't do anything that jumped off the
ball. You move a little faster because you know you're getting it.
Ready, Scott.
They take the ball out of the game and give it to Connor on the bench. Boyle, you still got your ball from your first goal as a cannon?
Well, it was from the barrage, not the cannons.
The barrage, that's right, Philadelphia barrage.
Sold it on eBay.
Talk about a greaser. That ball is like 48 years old.
It's brown.
Yeah.
Philadelphia hosting both the NCAA and PLL
Love
championships.
It. That spot where they have this PLL championship every year is great.
It's electric.
Nitty's Tavern.
That's the spot?
Oh, where we ate those two meals.
Oh, yeah.
Philly, folks. You're coming to Philly for the championship.
Schreiber to Manny, right? That was a magical combo. Now Schreiber's going to hit O'Keefe in a very similar manner.
Yes, I'll take O'Keefe over whatever goal totals Vegas put up to start the season.
Sisselberger powering his way in. Can't beat Gittleman.
You know, I called it earlier that Tommy Shriver's the best passing.
Now two with the timeout being used on that unsuccessful challenge. So Holman will have one more left in the second half. One by Bones. He shoots. Easy save for Dobson.
Magician. Deception is a mighty tool.
Archer's able to get a shot, but it's deflected as the horn sounds to end the first half.
You love this guy, right, Cotter?
Love it. I just love his intensity. He brings it on every single play, every minute of every game, brings it in his preparation work. It's all about the effort for Sisselberger.
You know what I love
redo
about
it
him too?
We'll redo this faceoff. Yeah.
Did you see how
first half
jacked up he was when he was drafted?
Yeah. Oh yeah. I would have given him his space at that point.
Yeah.
You know, like you gotta give him the radius around there just in case something goes flying. He wins this faceoff again, so he continues that great play in the first half to start the second half for Archers.
And for Stephen Bones Kelly, you.
This could be a couple of goals here in this 1 minute if Sisselberger can win this faceoff, but Bones isn't going to take it lightly.
And they've wisely put Schreiber on the faceoff wing, so one less substitution to get into their power play. It's a little early to use one of your timeouts, but you know this is an opportunity. You could take the game and just kind of squeeze the...
That's what I'm thinking. Yeah. I'm making that gesture.
Yeah.
Just because you really get into a flow on the power play here.
Ambler. Here's Schreiber up. Largest lead of the night for Archers. 5-0 run, and Sisselberger with another faceoff win. Still man up for Archers.
Sisselberger will be interesting to watch this summer. He's got big time ability.
And how much time he's going to log, because we've already seen it with these faceoff guys with Baptiste in the first game. They're on the field a lot more than they're used to being on the field.
The way he hit the brakes before he got the goal line extended, I think that caught Gittleman off guard, because Adam's a goalie on that play that loves to come out and deliver a hit when a defender turns a man towards an inside roll. But there was something about it that made Adam hesitate, and I think he just hit the brakes earlier than anticipated.
Marvel's job is staying out of the crease as well. Here he is on the other side.
Well, people seem to forget, what was he, number two? Berger's domination at the stripe is putting so much pressure on this Cannons defense. They're gassed.
He's won 12 of 15 coming into this faceoff. That one's going to roll out of bounds, and it's going to be Archer's ball.
This is an offense that led the PLL in scoring. Can they capitalize, though, on an offensive goal? They got a break. Can they win a faceoff in a critical spot? The answer is yes.
And Bones. This is where, if I'm Bones, I keep Sisselberger out there.
Yeah.
Keep him out there.
Point.
Get
great
him involved
point.
In the pick game. Get him on balls
without bouncing. So credit him for mixing it up there.
And getting the first two-point goal of the season early on the first day. Sisselberger wins it, but now gets possession back to Cannons. Too much traffic, and Trainer comes out of there with it. Now he's looking for some help. Finds it in Holman.
At the ball, he's got to know the scout. You got to stay attached to the hip with LeClaire.
So that's inside. You got to have your head on a swivel and have your stick on him to feel him when he moves away from you.
I mean, I doubt he was the slide guy there,
but that's just it. A lot of times when you trap someone who's not accustomed to playing a stretch shooter, you don't know the space that that player needs to get that type of shot off.
File
shots using the turf.
And they called that a one. I think I just got a little excited there by the potential 13-yard arc.
Yeah, Reese had to take that faceoff because Bones had a violation on his last attempt. Sisselberger is still in there. Look at the strength. Gets it to Amen, who gets a great look.
Grant's always looking to deal. Sometimes you have to take it yourself, spray some nylon. And Grant Amen spends so much time in the offseason shooting with both hands.
Sisselberger made that play, guys.
Sisselberger ran through multiple checks, Quint.
And then, he was terrific. There was a violation against Bones Kelly, so Matt Reese took the draw, and they're going to press out on Sisselberger. They were shutting off everybody, making the rookie out of Lehigh run, and 99 was able to protect his stick and get away and make the play. So that was kind of a moment where he was vulnerable, I thought.
Bar down accuracy there.
Sisselberger's got to get some oxygen.
Yeah. Well, that's what this new 32 does.
A lot of running.
You're going to run, and you're going to run often, but you can't give Grant Ament that much time. But you saw his brain, too. He was looking to pass.
Trainer got the ground ball, but he got hammered. Flags all over the place. Now we'll get a whistle. Just 0.6 seconds left to go.
Vicious checks, Kyle. Yeah. Down here, field level.
Kyle's talent is undeniable, and what he does as an ambassador for the game cannot go undervalued. But the Cannons now have an opportunity as a team to really click on all cylinders and push themselves to do things differently, right? I mean, that's the reality.
They have to, yeah.
Like, they should be a team that should thrive and strive to be one of the best teams in terms of passing, assisted goals this year, getting everyone involved and spreading it.
Well, this is a big part of it here. Man up. for a minute to start this, almost a minute here to start this fourth quarter. Pass inside to Donville, can't finish it.
A little bit, but to me, crashing the boards shows me your toughness, but it also shows me your hands, right? Because you have a fraction of a second to pick that ball up in traffic.
Yeah, not a garbage goal. I think I said blue, right?
That's what I mean. I didn't say you called it garbage. You called it a borderline garbage.
There's
no such thing. I'm actually like seconding your thought. And then early offense, right? The defense isn't set up. You're coming with a full head of steam out of the box.
Sisselberger on the run. He scores again!
Come on, Sis, give us a celebration.
He's saying, I need a breather.
He's tapping out.
I don't need a celebration.
He's tapping out.
I need a breather.
He's too tired to celebrate. When he was drafted in the first round by the Archers, he exploded while watching it at an establishment near Lehigh where he went to college. You're thinking the first goal right down the heart of the defense, and this is the exclamation point on a day where he dominated the stripe. This is the payoff. I mean, he's been fantastic. The one glaring weakness of a team in week one now looks like a strength.
This is the missing piece for this team. Last year, it was a revolving door at the faceoff stripe.
Q's down there with Sis. What's going on?
Mike, how would you best describe this debut, this first opportunity as a pro?
In one word, I would say blessed. Blessed to be here. Blessed for the opportunity. I'm blessed to be along some of the best guys in the world. Love these guys. At least kind of redemption for me. Had the USA tryout this fall. Ended up not making it. So I came into this with a huge chip on my shoulder to prove I belong. And I'm trying to do that today.
What is most difficult?
Taking the big checks.
The wing guys.
The wing guys. They're closer. They're bigger. They're faster. But hold on. Oh, yeah.
So Cotter wants to wrestle you in a match.
No way.
Where's Connor?
Farrell?
No, Cotter. Chris Cotter.
Cotter.
Our booth guy.
Bring him down. We'll do
he's
it right
he's
at
similarly
the X.
Built.
We'll do it right at the X. Bring him down. One takedown. You know the rules.
Yeah.
I know the rules. It's be over in a hurry.
I'll best describe what's most difficult. Catching your breath.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The oxygen, man. I mean, he has been working today. A goal, an assist. He's won
guys,
18 to 23 faceoffs.
Archer's foul, number nine.
Colin Kerr's coming in to spell Adam Gittleman.
Yeah, there's Colin Kirsten. When you watch him and his upside and his size, I just think he could be a pro for a long time. And this combination of the seasoned veteran and Gittleman, and now the second-year pro out of Rutgers, gives you some options if you're Brian Holman.
Sisselberger wins it, yet another faceoff. So Archer's up.
Yeah, we got a great goalie.
Yeah, I think you know, one of Adam's strengths he's going to add to this team is that maturity, that team guy, you know, extending his career, coming here. He'll play some goal. He'll start some games. He'll back up some games, but he's going to be a great teammate. That's the greatest thing that he'll bring to this Cannons franchise.
Love the honesty and candor on the sideline with that question cue. That's
yeah, that's not that's an easy position.
No, that's professionalism. Now Schreiber. Now we're gonna get a flag. This is gonna go against Cannons.
There's a flag on the field.
And Fields is feeling it. I feel like number five is. Hey, you talk about the intensity. Water Dogs, the defending champs, were scrimmaging against Cannons, and they were down 9-1 in that game. The Cannons, you know, Coach Copeland said we came out there like, hey, all happy and proud of ourselves for being the champions. And the Cannons were hungry. Sisselberger this time can't get a shot off, but he draws a lot of attention.
You know what it is, Cotter? There's so many new faces on the Cannons. And what does that... Who
yep.
can spray the ball from deep downtown at 100 miles an hour. And you have Marcus Holman at the point, who's the most accurate shooter in the PLL. So now... You have the tools that you didn't have in a scenario last year. You have them now.
And Aslanian's got that type of range as well.
It's Archer's ball.
Love watching him play. You know, when you cover lacrosse and you see a player like him that just flows.
Oh, great look. Fields. What a save, though, by Kirst right on the doorstep.
You saw on that fast break the gravity of Mac O'Keefe. What a pickup.
And here comes O'Keefe.
They got numbers.
They do, out of the box. Amen can't handle
a second of that pass. Like, he knows Nolting's on the backside, but he doesn't show the defense's eyes to Nolting until the last second.
This is why you drafted Sisselberger in the first round. Up to in the final minute and a half, you need possession, and you might get a goal. Now we get a timeout. We do.
Well, this is a sneaky part of the 32-second shot clock. Normally, you'd be able to run out.
Yep, great point. Great point. Yeah, you'd leave them with what, just 10, 12 seconds? Now, you leave them with a ton of juice left.
So
one possession game. You drop a two ball.
Are you more apt than I know at Sisselberger?
This is the spot why you drafted Michael Sisselberger. I mean, he's been amazing today at 77%.
Bones wins that draw. And Coach Holman immediately calls a timeout. Down three with 45.6 remaining. Going to go into the huddle.
Some goaltending. How about Michael Sisselberger playing with a chip on his shoulder? Something to prove as a rookie. He answered the bell.
Well, you look at their two new guys, new pieces. Sisselberger at the stripe goes 24 for 30. Dobson with 16 saves. Shoring up those specialty spots.